Jordan, strategic partner at L'Alliance. Welcome to the afternoon session dedicated to the presentation of the different innovation hubs and health incubators in France. How can you successfully expand your business in the French healthcare market with their help? At the end of the session, we also are going to have a presentation of Business France to help you expand your French business abroad and more specifically in the US. After this inbound transmission session, Bayer G4A, which is the team dedicated to digital health partnership and investment at Bayer, is going to give a talk on how digital health can help to overcome public healthcare challenges. And then the last session, but not the least, of this French day, we will have a pitch contest with several startups pitching in front of a French panel of investors. So now, by order of appearances, we will have Institut du Médicament de Strasbourg. We have Semia, Pulsalis, Medicalps, Atlantpol, Eurasanté, and Business France. So now we are waiting for Jean-Christophe Roberts from Institut du Médicament that will appear in a few minutes.
Okay, so thank you to the organizer, to L'Alliance and Giant to give me the opportunity to present my institute, so the Institut du Médicament de Strasbourg, IMS, that could be translated in Strasbourg Institute for Drug Discovery and Development. So this institute is part of the larger excellence initiative from the University of Strasbourg called Interdisciplinary Thematic Institute. So the IMS was created in January this year for a period of 8 years. Next slide, please. The previous one.
C'est bon, Jean-Christophe?
Non.
Je suis sur la deuxième slide.
Ah, je vois la troisième, moi.
Ah, alors il y a un gros décalage.
Ah, here we are. So the IMS is based on 10 years of experience within the Laboratory of Excellence Medalis from 2011 to 2020. That was the first level of structuration of the drug discovery in the Strasbourg University. So here are listed some of our achievements in terms of formation of PhD, of postdocs. We filed over more than 600 publications, patents and license, and we are very proud to say that we launched 7 startup companies and 2 being created this year. We have also a leverage effect of in terms of jobs, so direct and indirect jobs, and we raise more than 12 million euros, so quite half for the labs and half for the companies we created. Next slide, please.
Yes. C'est fait, mais...
There's a delay.
So... Yes, what I could say it in when the slide will appear is that the IMS is based in 3 main action lines, so research that we still call Medalis as a trademark, education with an educational program called the EURIDIS, and INEDIS tech transfer action that I'm directing. If we can jump to the fourth slide.
Yeah.
Ah, sorry, I don't see. I see still the second one. So.
Ouais, mais j'ai changé, hein, Jean-Christophe.
Okay. So, are you sure that everybody see the fourth? Yes, anyway, let's continue. So the medalist action line is mainly research action lines. It's based on the 12 teams, 12 academic teams, for half biologists and half chemists. And the platform at the interface, which is the PDCBs platform, which is a high throughput screening platform and AdMetOx platform. We are mainly working with annual calls for proposal open to all the Strasbourg community. And we are very focused on IP and tech transfer. And it's not the right slide, sorry. We have on board an advisory board, mainly composed of industrial partners, so pharma industry, experts from pharma industry, chemist industry, and IP specialists. This board meets every 6 months to review our projects and give our advice on milestones and go/no-goes in this program. So our research program are funded from 12 months up to 24 months and no more. We enter in a wide therapeutic field, but our current pipeline is mainly based on the oncology approach, inflammation disease, and innovative technology for drug discovery. So next slide, please.
Oui, j'ai déjà changé.
Ah, sorry. Yes. So our educational program is interdisciplinary graduate school with mainly education in the way of drug discovery. And we are still working at the interface between chemistry, biology, and legal. So it's a really innovative and professionalizing educational program, which is focused, as I say, in tech transfer, in entrepreneurship, and all the students receive a mentor from academia and a mentor from industry. So for this program, we have a financial support from Laboratoire Pierre Fabre, Laboratoire Servier. We are in really advanced discussion to have funding, and we are very supported by Région Grand Est. Next slide.
Ouais.
So the third action line is the INEDIS, which is the acronym for Innovation and Entrepreneurship in Drugs Discovery. And the mission of INEDIS is really to ensure the transformation in good condition of an academic research project into an entrepreneurial project. So the idea is to support and structure the startup in the pre-startup creation phase. And we, the IMS and INEDIS, offer open labs action to the young company in order to not disrupt the continuum of research and continue to generate some results. So we have on board an experienced transfer advisory board that will help us to work on the development plan and to finally identify the key person to build the team around this entrepreneurial project. So we also create a dedicated fund for pre-seed money. We have already an investor on board, and we work also on co-development action with the first of a long series, I hope, a very large European biotech, which is now working with us. So next slide.
Continuez, Jean-Christophe, j'ai l'impression que ça a frisé.
It's the right one. Okay. So I will present in a few words our transfer advisory board, which is composed by Dr. Julie Ralsin from Alliance Entrepreneur, Jean-François Rax from a local fund called Capital Grand Est, Dr. Hélène Perrault-Saint-Paul from Aura Healthcare, Alban Stam from the French Bank for Public Investment, Zaki Zelam, which is a serial entrepreneur in the Basel area and a corporate strategy advisor, and Xingzong Joel Zhao, capital fund in Sofinnova Partners. So, just in time, one of the last slides. So, we want is not to work alone, but we work really closely with Semia, the local incubator for a startup, which we'll talk just after me. SatConnectus, our transfer office, and BioValley France. Well, what we really want is really to focus investment capabilities with investors, international private investors, but also public funding. We have already established some partnership, as I told you before, with biotech or industry, and we really would like to build around this industrial chairs and business development mentoring from the team around the project of startup. We established also finally some partnership with engineering school in chemistry, biotechnology and physics and management school in order that this young engineers are would be really welcome to work within our structure for an internship. And finally, last slide, please. Finally, I hope that I convince you that innovation is not just research, and please feel free to contact me. Normally, you will see my email and the internet website of IMS. So thank you for hearing me, despite the conditions and the connections problem. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jean-Christophe. So now we are waiting for Guillaume from Semia, who is going to talk about Semia. So he's going to appear in a few seconds, I hope.
The opportunity to present our incubator, Semia. I'm Guillaume Vetter-Genoux, Head of Healthcare Department at Semia. Next slide. Semia is a member of the Quest for Change network, five incubators located in Grand East region in Strasbourg, Mulhouse, Épinal, Metz, Reims, and Charleville-Mézières. We are public and non-profit incubator. Our incubators are financed by the Grand East region, French Ministry of Research, European Union, and respective metropolis. Semia was created in 1999, has been recognized incubator of excellence by the Grand East region in 2018. This means also that we could prescribe a 30 kilo euros grant to our startups. At the national level in 2019 and 2020, the consortium BioValley France, SatConnectus, IHU, and Semia has been awarded of the French Tech Seed. It means if startups have fundraised, they can have access to non-dilutive funding up to 250 kilo euros. And has been one of the nine winners of the national programs for incubators and accelerators supporting deep techs. This major part of this program is to boost market access on international development for health tech startups. Next slide. In 2018, the team was totally renewed and a new paradigm on methodology has been established. One of the singularities of our incubators is that every business manager has been former entrepreneur. In other words, in our incubators, entrepreneurs talk to entrepreneurs. Next slide. So with a new dynamic in 2 years, we have gone from 10 people on 28 incubated projects to 33 people, and we are currently incubating 220 startups covering multiple sectors. Next slide. About 60 of our startups are digital, 15 in the industry, and about 25 are biotech and medtech. 100 new startups are incubated each year now, and we are really proud to show a survival rate of 75% 5 years after the creation of startups. Next slide. So with 70 deep tech startups currently incubated, and about 55 startups on this morning, five more in healthcare, we are proud to be the first French healthcare incubator. Half of the startups are coming from public and the other half from private sectors. About 30% of our startups are not originating from Grand East regions, and they are coming from US. For instance, Palo Alto, Houston, a spin-off of Harvard Medical School, but also Japan, Switzerland, Israel, and other regions of France. Quantity does not exclude quality. 25% of our startups have been rewarded at national or international level. Next slide. Here is a sample of recent success stories. Top left, RDS, a medtech established at IRCAD, has fundraised $4 million this year. They develop a connected patch to monitor the main vital parameters of patients after surgery. After initial development in Palo Alto, they moved to Strasbourg. Their CEO is Elie Lobel, former director of Orange Healthcare, and their president, Sam Ellett, former CEO of Applied Biosystems. It's a center, a biotech company, a spin-off from Harvard Medical School, which has already fundraised $5.2 million this year. Top right, Biodel Therapeutics, a biotech which developed a first-class component for the treatment of neuropathic pain and has fundraised $4.5 million last year. Next slide. Regarding steps and support process, we received about 300 applications per year and about 50 are incubated, 15 in healthcare. Projects are subject to a two-step selection process. First, an internal selection phase following by a presentation by the co-founding team to an external and expert engagement committee. So what are our selection criteria? Without any surprise, the team on the team, the innovative character of the project, which was made covered up by a strong IP, a validated market, a minimal proof of concept, for instance, for biotech project, first in vivo efficacy studies on appropriate animals models, and for medtech, a first functional prototype. After the approval, the co-founder benefits from a personalized support and will have access to a dedicated business manager with an expertise in the field, access to a panel of sectorial experts, and also certified service provider from Senia, access to local, national, but also international partners and initiatives, and access to a supporting financial engineering and a complete innovation funding chain. For instance, case one, with only 300 kilo euros fundraise, you can have access to 1.1 million euros corresponding to a non-dilutive leverage from BPI France and Gantis region. Case two, if the project is deep tech with 2 million fundraise, you can have access up to 2.5 million of grants on non-dilutive leverage. To conclude, our support is not time limited, but monitored every 6 months with an external committee of experts until they exceed that correspond to the achievement of major milestones such as Series A fundraising or a major cooperation agreement. Next slide. So why do high potential projects emerge locally or choose to come here to develop their projects? One strong point is that they have access to a unique innovation ecosystem that is internationally known in the field of life sciences, but more importantly, one that is totally aligned and easily mobilized. Next, the incubator is the University of Strasbourg, which is an international reference in life sciences. 5 Nobel Prizes are in activity on, according to the journal Nature, Strasbourg is the first European university in innovation, 16 in the world. Only a few steps away from the incubator is the IRCAD, a center of excellence for minimally invasive surgery, directed by Professor Jacques Maresco, who was the first surgeon to perform a remote operation between New York and Strasbourg in 2001. Next to the IRCAD is the IRSU, an international center of excellence for image-guided surgery. In the same area is NextMed, 30,000 square meters dedicated to medtech, on which will host startups and major corporates such as Siemens, GE, Medtronic, Storz, and many others who are already present on the campus. Next slide. On the international side, with our German and Swiss partner, we organize international health tech events to connect innovative startups on the ecosystems to promote international cooperation with a dual challenge. First, a better understanding of market specificities in order to reinforce the roadmap or the market access strategy for startups. Second, the opportunity to network with nearby startups, but also to be visible to major corporate and international investors and meet them individually. Next slide. During the last edition, 70 startups were pre-selected by major corporate and investors, you see here on the screen. And 110 individual meetings were scheduled in one afternoon, and for your information of 70 startups, 5 closed and 2 others are currently in due diligence. The next editions will be organized the 13th and 14th of October. Save the date. Next slide. I'm really proud to present you all the members of the Deep Tech team. This brings me to the end of my presentation. Next slide. If you are a startup, an investor, a corporate, or have any questions, please feel free to contact us. Thank you very much for your attention.
So thank you.
Guillaume, I have an issue. You okay? It's
okay for me. Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Alliance on Giant.
And thank you, Joseph, to join us. Sorry for the delay. So are you able to share your screen? Are you ready for that? I need for me to stop sharing, if I can, yes. So perfect, it works.
So should I leave?
Sorry?
Should I leave now? Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, you can leave. You click on the red button.
Okay, nice.
And so, André, you can go. Joseph, sorry.
No problem. Do you still see the full screen presentation? Do you see the full screen presentation? Or just
not the full screen yet.
Okay. So I hope there is not too much delay.
I think there's a few delay, but okay. Go ahead because we are already running late.
Yeah, never mind. Okay,
I'm sorry about that.
Thank you, Lalliance. Thank you, Giant, for this opportunity to present Lyon and Pulsalis and why Lyon is a great place to do research and to develop new businesses into the health tech field. So, well, you might think Lyon is a great place because we are only 2 hours away by train from Paris, 2 hours from the mountain and 2 hours from the sea, but there is much more than this great geographical location to be interested in to come to Lyon. So in terms of academic environment, of course, you will find a great opportunities to develop new collaboration agreements with leading scientific teams, as well as doing contract research to gain access on your own intellectual property. But we can offer also exclusive and state-of-the-art equipment into academic platforms. And of course, Pulsalis, the entity I work for, will be your partner in terms of technology transfer if you want to get access to patents, know-how, or other intellectual patrimony coming from the University of Lyon. Speaking of the University of Lyon, it's a great university that hosts more than 170 laboratories in different field. The life science field and health tech field is one of the most important fields in the university, and it gathers more than 6,800 scientists, full-time scientists, and more than 5,000 PhD students every year. So it's a huge university, a very important cluster for the academic research. But if you're a company, you will want you to come to Lyon for not only the universities, but also the other academic institution, and also to get access to the unique facilities that are in Lyon. I don't think that you see my screen, but in Lyon we host a P4 laboratory. So if you're interested in infectious disease, you'll get access to one of the few laboratories that can work in on very dangerous disease, viruses and bacteria. We also host offices from the World Health Organization, as well as the International Agency for Research on Cancer. So it's a great place to meet people that will be involved globally into the development of new products for the health tech field and the life sciences. And also to stay on the clinical side, the Hospice Civil de Lyon, which are university hospital here in Lyon, will help you to set up your clinical trials, as they have a strong experience that they've had in the past, managed to conduct more than 2,000 clinical trials. And if you are dedicated to in oncology, you will be interested in working with the Centre Léon Bérard, which is a clinic that is dedicated to treatment but also research on cancer and on oncology, and it gathered 500 researchers dedicated to this field, to this indication. So as a company, you will want to have partners, other companies, and you will find them by joining many of the different clusters of companies that you'll find here in Lyon. In the health tech field, the most notable cluster would be Lyon Biopole, that is dedicated to life sciences, and other branch that is dedicated to medical devices and e-health, that is eye care. But you could be also interested in the TechTerra cluster, that is also a space dedicated to innovative textile and has a long history with Lyon and the silk industry, for example. Just to mention a few of the clusters that we have a partnership with, to keep on like this, as a company, cash is king, and there are a few ways to get funding here in Lyon. Of course, Pulsalis is the first investor in the project that comes from the University of Lyon, and about the ability to invest up to sometimes 500,000 euros per project to go from the proof of concept to a more mature project. But you will find other public subsidiaries, and of course, BPI France, as a French public bank of investments, will brought you non-dilutive investment as well as dilutive financing based on leverage on equity. And that can go from 30,000 euros up to more than 5 million euros in some cases. And more dedicated, more specific to the Lyon region, it's the Auvergne-Rhône-Alpes region, and that brings subsidies for a consortium of academics and companies from more than 2,000 euros to up to 1 million euros. So it can help you to go from your early stage development to a later stage and more mature projects. Beyond this public funding, Lyon is a great place also to find your first investors, whether it could be equity crowdfunding through a dedicated platform that is Instit Financement, that gather more than 500 investors from single business angels, high net worth individuals, as well as association of business angels. But you will find also venture capitalists and corporate venture capitalist companies that are operating in Lyon and investing in companies from France, obviously, but from Lyon also. To name just a few of them, it's not a dedicated list, but we have a strong interaction with Sofimac Innovation, with CREAXI and Mela Development, all of them that have been involved in recent fundraising companies such as MakeBrain, MapLink, or Gauma Therapeutics. Just to finish, there's a quick overview of Lyon. Well, I think in Lyon you will find a great academic laboratory with state-of-the-art equipment and facilities. We host international institutions and agencies that will grant you a global view on your opportunities to develop your project and your company. Speaking of company, there is this dense network of innovative companies federated by those clusters and attractive funding from public organization as well as investors from early stage to the late stage funding. So what I want to say is that in one word, welcome to Lyon, you will not be alone. So welcome to Lyon.
Thank you very much, Joseph, and thank you for the presentation. I with the technical issues, I'm not completely sure that we saw the presentation, but I'm sorry about that.
No, it's okay.
So welcome, Grégory. It seems that when I share the presentation, it works quite well. So let's try that. So Joseph, if you can stop sharing your screen.
Yep.
Then I will share mine, and we can start. And we are running late, so let's go. I don't know if you see my screen.
I do.
Okay, so go ahead, and I will. You say next, and I will go to the next slide.
Okay, thank you. Hello, everyone. I am Grégory Vernier, and I am the General Manager of Medicults. So first of all, I would like to thank the Giant Health and Alliance organization for inviting me and letting me the opportunity to present my ecosystem. So Medicults is the health tech cluster of the French Alps. Next, please. I'm going to introduce briefly my organization, which has been established more than 20 years ago now. This is a non-profit organization and a business association gathering stakeholders in healthcare technologies in my region, which is the French Alps and specifically Grenoble in France. So we gather today more than 100 members, and most members are innovative companies that are designing and manufacturing medical devices. At least 65% of my members are medical device stakeholders. And we also have a lot of suppliers and service providers that are dedicated to the medical device industry. So we have the chance to have also the support of large companies such as Becton Dickinson, Roche Diagnostic, Medtronic, or Twixel. So most of our members are startups. 80% of my members are below 50 salaries. And this is a young ecosystem. We can mention that this is a young ecosystem and very dynamic. And among the members of my cluster, they have raised over 200 million euros the last 3 years. And this is a significant number at the European scale. The message you can keep in mind is that the ecosystem is mainly composed of startups. And we estimate that we represent almost 10% of the medical device industry, since in France you have roughly between 1,000 and between 1,500 companies as manufacturers in medical device industry, and 800 biotech companies in France. And yes, we do represent roughly 10% of the industry. Next slide, please. So I'm going to tell you more about where we are coming from and what our ecosystem is about. So first of all, our region is has a long history in science. The Grenoble area is the second.
Absolutely.
Sorry. Okay.
No, go ahead.
Sorry. The Grenoble area is the second research hub in France, and we host more than 25,000 researchers in private and public sectors. And we host major national research centers, such as the CERA or one of the fourth AI institute in France. We also have the chance to have major European research facilities settled down in our town. We can count not less than 6 Nobel Prizes coming from researchers connected in our region. So this world-class research hub has really fueled a very high-tech-oriented industry for decades. And you can see on the right side of the slide some big names in various sectors. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Wow, thank you. Regarding the healthcare industry, you can mention the presence of 8 industry leaders, such as BD, Roche, Fresenius, Biomedio, and so on. We have a combined turnover of over 4 billion euros, combining all these medical companies in our area. And what we can also mention is the presence of very dynamic hospitals that are conducting over 1,000 clinical trials a year, which is quite a good figure in the field. This whole ecosystem paved the way to facilitate the startup creation in healthcare during the last decade. Next slide, please. Now I would like to provide you an overview of our companies you can find. As I told you before, we can find 200 companies in a very diverse range of segments with a vast majority of SMEs. Starting from the upper left, you can see the artificial pancreas from Diabiloop. Then the surgical navigation system from Surgery Video, a point of care device for the in vitro diagnostic with Avalon on the upper right, and other image guided technologies that we can find a lot in our ecosystem, and wearables such as a pain management system from Remedy Lab in the middle down of the slide. As I told you, those companies have raised a lot of money the last few years, and we try to help them out to grow as a cluster. And this is the topic of the next slide. I know there's a lag. Okay. What we can do is to support the growth of our companies, and we have three main missions. I won't go into the details because it's going to be too long, and I'm fully available afterwards if you want more details. We can say that we try to enhance visibility to connect people in our ecosystem and outside of the ecosystem, and we provide services to these companies to support their business development. We provide workshops, trainings. We share resources. We share knowledge with our ecosystem and companies. We can set up collaborative program. We can find fundings for those projects. And we also have, I would say, big projects to develop the ecosystem. And this is also the topic of the next slide. As an example, we have set up a showroom to highlight the excellence of our healthcare sector in our area. And the idea also is to provide a space for showcasing technologies, but also a place to connect people within our ecosystem. And then for the final slide, and another example of one of our program to develop, to help our company develop their businesses. We are organizers of MedFit, which is a leading European partnering event for innovation partnerships and investment rounds in the medtech, diagnostic, and digital healthcare sectors. The next edition will take place in a digital format between the 7th and the 9th of December this year. So don't hesitate to go on the website and to know more about this event. The idea is to gather together large companies, startups, SMEs, investors, all together to facilitate connection and deal between stakeholders. Thank you very much. I hope I want to launch.